Well, hello and welcome back to Noah's Window. We're in the series, we're talking about some of the lyrics of the songs that we sing at New Spring and the scripture behind those. And again, I'm going to choose something today that's a little different. Back in 2020, when COVID was just breaking and we were just finding out that we were going to be quarantined and life was just being turned upside down, we weren't even going to be able to meet at the church, and it just seemed like it just seemed so unsettling and so difficult and so hard to understand. And I was driving down the road and this song came on and it just captured my heart. And I had to stop and thank the Lord for sending that song to me. And as soon as I got to the rest of the staff, I had to share it with them. And it was so meaningful to me. And as we were doing those early days of Noah's Window, our worship team did this song. And the name of this song is Sometimes He Calms the Storm. Now, it refers back to really a story that we find in Matthew chapter 14. And it's interesting if you go and get your Bible out and read this whole chapter, because there's a story about John the Baptist first. And then it talks about Jesus feeding the 5,000. You're probably familiar with that story. And right after Jesus fed the 5,000, he sends the disciples into a boat to go on the other side of the Sea of Galilee while he dismisses the crowd. And of course, Jesus knew what was coming, but the disciples didn't. And these disciples a lot of them were fishermen, so they're very acquainted, well acquainted with the Sea of Galilee. But they were going across, and it was probably getting dark at this point. And this is what happened. Let me read a little bit to you. And starting in verse 22, immediately after this, after Jesus had fed the 5,000, Jesus insisted that his disciples get back into the boat and cross to the other side of the lake while he sent the people home. After sending them home, he went up into the hills by himself to pray. Night fell while he was there alone. So this means the disciples are out in the boat and it's nighttime. And this was before electric lights, okay? So they're out there in the dark. Meanwhile, the disciples were in trouble far away from land, for a strong wind had risen, and they were fighting heavy waves. About 3 o'clock in the morning, Jesus came toward them, walking on the water. When the disciples saw him walking on the water, they were terrified in their fear, and they cried out, "It's a ghost!" But Jesus spoke to them at once. "Don't be afraid," he said. "Take courage. I'm here." Then Peter called to him, "Lord, if it's really you, tell me to come to you walking on the water." "Yes, come," Jesus said. Peter went over the side of the boat and walked on the water toward Jesus, but when he saw the strong wind and the waves, he was terrified and began to sink. "Save me, Lord," he shouted. Jesus immediately reached out and grabbed him. "You have so little faith," Jesus said. "Why did you doubt me?" When they climbed back into the boat, and I think this is significant, okay, the timing of this. When they climbed back into the boat, the wind stopped. Then the disciples worshipped him. "You really are the Son of God," they exclaimed. But notice how these events unfold. When the storm is raging, Jesus approaches, and here's what he told them: "Take courage, I'm here." He could have stopped the storm right then, but he didn't. He told the disciples, "Take courage, I'm here. The storm is still raging. You're in the boat, I'm on the water, but I'm here with you." And that, I believe, is what the message of this song is. And let me read the song lyrics to you. "All who sail the sea of faith find out before too long how quickly blue skies can grow dark and gentle winds grow strong. Suddenly, fear is like white water pounding on the soul. Still, we sail on, knowing that our Lord is in control. Sometimes he calms the storm with the whispered, 'Peace be still.' He can settle any storm, any sea, but it doesn't mean he will. Sometimes he holds us close and lets the wind and waves go wild. Sometimes he calms the storm, and other times he calms his child. He has a reason for each trial that we pass through in life, and though we're shaken, we cannot be pulled apart from Christ. No matter how the driving rain beats down on those who hold the faith, a heart of trust will always be a quiet, peaceful place." Now, in the midst of a storm, these are such comforting words to me and such a wonderful song. I hope you'll enjoy listening to it today. Whatever storm you might be going through, or maybe you're headed into a storm you don't even know about yet, but just keep in mind that whether God chooses to calm that storm or just to carry you through it, he is faithful and he will see you through. So I hope that encourages your heart today. Let's have a word of prayer. Oh, Father, we're so thankful that you are the almighty, powerful God who can calm any storm And eventually, Father, we know you will calm all storms and you will carry us over to the other side where everything will be in order and peaceful and provided. And all the things that we've longed for in this life, you will provide in the life to come. But in the meantime, Father, we want to be faithful servants and we want to be faithful to trust you when the storms are raging, knowing that we can have courage because you are here and you promised us that nothing can separate us from your love and your presence. Thank you for that, Father. For each and every person who's watching or listening to Noah's Window today, I just pray that you would comfort their hearts, whatever they're going through or whatever they're about to go through. I pray that you give them that peace that only you can provide in the middle of a storm, that you would give them that courage and the faith. And as we come out on the other side of the storm, help us to look back and remember how powerful you are and how faithful you are. And we're going to thank you for all the things that you have done, are doing, and are going to do still yet. And we're going to ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, I hope you've been enjoying this series. It's been a wonderful blessing to Mark and myself. We've really enjoyed it. Thank you for those of you who reach out with suggestions. Those of you who've reached out with verses for our road trip, we've collected those. I think we've got 15 now. So we may be doing those for a while, even after we get home. But thank you so much for getting those to us, because that's such a blessing. So I pray that you have a wonderful day, and we'll look forward to seeing you next time on Noah's Window. God bless.